A few moments ago, Buckingham Palace announced the death of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. The palace has just issued this statement. It says the Queen died peacefully at Balmoral this afternoon. The King and the Queen Consort will remain at Balmoral this evening and will return to London tomorrow. Within the past few minutes, Buckingham Palace has announced the death of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. To recap on the statement, the Queen died peacefully at Balmoral this afternoon. The King, that is Charles, and the Queen Consort will remain at Balmoral this evening and will return to London tomorrow.
What is it you like to talk about?
My patient. Hi. I know you're nervous. I just want to have a chat.
I'm seeing something no one else can see except for me. It's smiling at me.
Yesterday, a patient in your care died brutally in front of you.
I need to find an explanation for what happened.
It's smiling at me. It's smiling at me.
Found 20 cases involving 19 victims with a direct line linking them all together.
You said only 19. Why is it that everybody else who's seen it is dead and you're alive? I've seen it too.
You?
Get away from me!
How long between each victim's death?
None of them survived longer than a week.
Today is my fourth day.
I am not gonna keep running.
I have to face it.
How does it make you feel?
I'm just really scared that something bad is going to happen.
I guess it's still time to do that, given that we are just exactly halfway through between our Western New Year and the Lunar New Year, which will loom in a few weeks' time. I think it's also appropriate to wish ourselves a Happy New Year, given what I would like to talk to you about, which has to do with the global economy and what we should expect for 2014. Now, I'm going to test you numerology skills by asking you to think about the magic seven.
First 2023, the following things will go into effect, and people need to be aware of this. It abolishes cash bail for almost every offense. This includes, but isn't limited to, kidnapping, armed robbery, second degree murder, drug-induced homicide, aggravated DUI, threatening a public official, and aggravated fleeing and eluding.
This is not a test. This is your emergency broadcast system announcing the commencement of the
Whenever the Fuck You Want Purge.
Sanctioned by the
Chicago
government.
Folks, welcome back. So just a quick poll here. That dog better shut the I'm filming a video. It's not my dog. Let's do a quick poll here. How many people have seen one of the Purge movies? You know, where they have this lady come on the radio. She sounds real official and serious. She says, well, you have 24 hours to pretty much do whatever the hell you want in terms of killing people, robbing places. Pretty much nothing is illegal. Now here's the other side to that. What makes something illegal? It's usually the consequence attached to doing something, right? So jail, you get arrested. Well, in 2023, a law is going to go into effect called the Safety Law or Safety Act. And as confusing as this may sound, the translation to safety in their eyes is the purge. So let me read this for a second. So the rules of this legitimate legal purge, for all of you who live in Illinois, let me read them off. Under the new law, entire categories of crimes such as aggravated batteries, robberies, burglaries, hate crimes, aggravated DUIs, vehicular homicide, drug-induced homicides, all drug offenses, including delivery of fentanyl, and trafficking cases are not eligible for detention, no matter the severity of the crime or the defendant's risk to a specific person or the community. The federal government just passed red flag laws. If you don't know what those are, you're probably new here. It's fine. But it's essentially where someone can call whoever the hell and say, hey, I think this guy's dangerous. Come and get his guns. Right? So that's a federal thing right now. But in Chicago, this is the key point. No matter the severity of the crime or the defendant's risk to a specific person. That is literally the definition of a red flag law. Someone who is dangerous to a certain person or has dangerous intentions. So go get his guns. Well, this is just really confusing. I'm trying to figure out if y'all in Chicago or Illinois who are running the state are just trying to come off stupid, or if you're just really stupid. Because I can't figure it out. This is moronic. But let's go over a few situations here just to see how this would play out. First of all, every single criminal in Illinois right now is clapping their hands. They probably got a birthday cake or a purge cake going. They're probably calling all their buddies saying, yeah, dude, we're gonna rock it 2023. Because you've essentially taken away law and order. Don't you get that? Aggravated batteries and robberies. So for example, an old woman's walking down the street. She can't drive anymore, it's not safe for her to drive, so she walks to the grocery store every day to get her milk, eggs, maybe some Cracker Jacks for those old Western movies she watches at 7:30. And one of these criminals in Illinois caught wind of this new act, Safety Act. So they go over there, they take her purse, they kick her in the face, and then, while all this is happening, a cop's watching, and they just wave to him. Hi, sir. Yeah, I just kicked her in the face, stole her purse. What are you doing later, though? You want to go get a coffee, talk about the game yesterday? I mean, that's essentially what you're asking people to do with this law. Here's my favorite one, though. And this is just, God bless it. I can't even explain how stupid this is. Drug-induced homicides. Homicide is when somebody kills someone else, not in self-defense. Right? There's a whole lot of that going on right now. So if you're a criminal and you want to commit a homicide and you see this new law, if you have half a brain, all you have to do is commit the homicide while you're on drugs. Then your public defender, your attorney, whatever, can say, oh no, it's a drug-induced homicide. It's right there in your Safety Act law. So it's, no. Every single criminal who commits a homicide in Chicago is going to claim it is a drug-induced homicide. It gets better, though. At the end, it says, the people have to prove by clear and convincing evidence that the person has a high likelihood of willful flight to avoid prosecution. If someone's on drugs and they just committed a homicide, do you think that it's going to be really easy for them to come to court? No, you make them by making them put up a lot of money called bail or a bond. They got to have a little bit of skin in the game or else there's no reason for them to show up. But there's a new part to that too. If someone gets charged with one of these crimes, they're out and free to do whatever the hell they want until their court date. Now, if they don't show up for their court date, the judge cannot issue a warrant on the first one. All they can do is they can try to summon them again and say, well, here's your new court date. Sorry you couldn't make it. Chicago traffic. No. They are only allowed to issue a warrant the second time they don't show up. You know the saying, you fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. I think y'all missed that in school or your dad's saying or something like that for whoever made this law. You know, it's been a long time since the crime rate in Chicago or any of these big cities has been at a level that we would call successful, right? Pretty low. But you know what they say about success, right? It's kind of like being pregnant. Everyone says congratulations, but nobody knows how many times you got fucked. That's what y'all are doing in all of the major cities. You're bending over every citizen that lives there and you're fucking them. This is going to cause so much blood in Chicago, it's going to be out of control. And this is just the first one to adopt this. All those super liberal cities, they're going to be right behind it. And eventually, when we get a new president or we get people who actually give a shit about human life, that's when we'll be successful. That's when the crime rate will go way down. But until then, if you live there, hope you like being bent over. Listen to this. This is Keith Peckow.
Offenders released on electronic monitoring have to be in violation for 48 hours before law enforcement can act. They could almost drive to Alaska before we can even look for them. It denies victims their constitutional rights. And keep this in mind, businesses and homeowners. Officers will no longer be able to remove trespassers from your residence or your businesses. Someone could decide to live in your shed, and all we can do is give them a ticket. You have to decide what level of force is required to remove them and whether or not it's legal.
So if someone comes into your home, cops are not allowed to remove them. So we can set up camp in there, be drinking a 40 while you're trying to teach your daughter math, and you have to decide whether or not you're going to shoot the guy, whether or not you're going to beat him up and drag him outside, throw him in the yard, or just ask him kindly to leave. And then what happens? What happens if people defend themselves in situations like this? What happens when the crime gets so bad that the decent people of Chicago who are going to defend themselves when crap like this is going to inevitably happen? Are you going to be as lenient on people who are defending their families with our Second Amendment? Or are you going to send ATF agents out there and say, well, you had a pistol brace, so yeah, that's not self-defense, man. Welcome to the Purge. If you like that kind of stuff, if you want to live in that kind of world, go out to Chicago. If you don't, I would get the hell out of Illinois. And if you have to stay there for some reason, arm yourself, because this is going to be nuts. Great job to whoever made this law or whatever the hell it is. And I really like the name, Safety Act. That is going to bite you in the ass. Just wait. You're going to see crime like you have never seen before, and it's all going to be because of the Safety Act. Genius.